talk briefly now about the router table. This is an incredibly useful device that allows us to use routers safely to do a number of operations. But like anything to do with routers, get it wrong and it can go very wrong. So we need to take great care. I suppose there's a couple of main things, operations we do with a router, in a router table. One of them is cutting truss rod slots. But we also do a variety of other tasks and shaping tasks. Now, the router table has got a machine like this one mounted down under there, turned upside down. So the it's sitting in there. It's sitting in there like this. And the whole machine is then wound up and down to adjust the depth. So there's a winder. Now this winder handle comes out of the table. It's got a hexagonal drive like an Allen key on it. Goes into this hole and we can rotate it, and the collet of the router comes up out of the table. Now because the router is so, it's down a little ways underneath the table, this is in fact what's called a collet extension. So it's an extension piece about this long. What that does is it allows us to get the collet up out of above the top of the table so that we can remove and install bits depending on what we require them to do. And then when we've got the bit in there, we simply wind it back down again. And then we can also use this to very accurately control the depth of cut, because the depth of cut will always be the distance above the table, and we can measure that quite accurately with rulers, etc. We typically use a couple of different fences. So for example, this fence, which can be mounted on the table, is the one we use for cutting, for doing radiusing fretboards. It can be used for a range of things. It's quite versatile. It can be adapted. The fence blocks can be moved in and out. The fence can be moved backwards and forwards to give different depths of cut. And it's really quite useful for a whole range of things. When we cut fretboards, we really want to have a very simple low fence. And so we have this fence, which we use in pretty much the same way. It gets attached to the table with a couple of hold down bolts, and we can line it up, move it in and out, and use that to line up our necks and cut truss rod slots. So that's the main job of that fence. I just want to point out one other routing tool that we use on the router table, and again this is for a very specific job. And that's this router. It's it's another one of those Makita quarter inch routers like the ones I showed you earlier. It's mounted in one of the Elevate binding jigs on this block of wood. We clamp the block of wood down onto the bench with these clamp down bolts, and this allows us to very accurately and simply cut the binding channels on acoustic guitar bodies, and electric guitar bodies and ukulele bodies for that matter. We use that here mounted this way. This time the router is horizontal, and we move the guitar body around to cut it. But that one, it's sort of a permanent fixture for this particular router. It's dedicated to doing just this one job, and it lives here above the router table.